Welcome to Horizon Zero Dawn, in which I take photographs of every frickin' thing. All the things. I just take one picture, then another picture, and sometimes they're mountains, and sometimes they're trees. And sometimes I take photos of cute NPCs, and sometimes of ugly ones. Welcome back, Josh Long. Sometimes I take pictures of tough lesbians with machine guns, and sometimes I take pictures of cuties with hot moms. So this is a thing. I'm going to be doing a lot of that as we play today. And let's check in. We're going to check in with the main quests. And I will tell you about where I'm at, because people always ask. They're like, how far in? Because spoilers, because it's a long game and maybe I'm playing it at my home with my own Super Nintendo Pro. So we'll do that first. We'll check in as soon as we start, so that if you are behind me and you don't want to get spiggity spoiled, you can chiggity check on out. Squad! We are growing, squad! Welcome to new members to Le Squad, to Lance and Thon in 2004. Alright, here we go. So, main quest check-in. Happy anniversary, Norse Ninja. Here's where we're at with the main quest. Eren's sister Ursa was kidnapped instead of slain. Many questions remain. This is a level 15 quest. My ass, way higher level than that shit. I've just been running around doing things, so we're not really that far into the main quest. I've done like two things since I got out of here, and I'm gonna continue that shit. We are just going to start the game by doing some exploring, and we're gonna pick up some quests, and we're gonna run around. We're just gonna just dick off. It'll be fine. Dick off. Rocket Orca. Welcome back, cutie.
My family might still be alive, and you're going to stand here and do nothing?
You've lost a dozen
Whoa, look at that guy's armor. No, come back here, ringmail. No, come here. You look like a Dark Souls character. You look like one of those sorcery guys. Don't do that. No, turn around. Okay, whatever, fuck you. All right,
tell me what happened to your family.
I'm a PC, so I could fix anything.
By the sun, I fear they are all dead by
cool.
Now. I barely escaped alive. Machines. Vicious machines attacked my family's estate. Father sent me to get help.
Vicious machines?
Welcome to the Math Squad.
Jones. Jones V. Welcome to
what
the squad.
What kind of machines? Where did they come from?
A Ravager. By the sun, how it cut.
Oh no, not a Ravager.
The Watchers came with it.
Ooh, I'm so scared.
The Sun King warned us that he could no longer protect freeholds beyond the valley, but Father never saw this coming.
Tell me more about the estate.
My father owns a dozen quarries.
Oh, I'm so excited to be playing this again.
The estate. Fine tapestries, custom woodwork.
You ever feel that
fixtures.
When you're like sitting down to play a game
but
and you have
the
controller in your
then?
Hand and you're just like the game is starting and you're just like
their lives are all that matter.
When I was a kid, I'm my sorry that I'm not like listening to this nerd, but whatever. When I was a kid, servants. Me and my brother, we would rent games and we would take them home and we would be so excited to play them that we would like eat dinner, and we would like clean our rooms or do whatever chores we had to do. So we had like several uninterrupted hours before bedtime, and we'd go downstairs and we would turn off the lights, and we'd close the door, and we would turn the TV up just like a little louder than usual, and we would tell our parents. We'd be like, "Mom, Dad, we gotta start a new video game. So just it's gonna be like a little louder because we want that cinematic experience on our like 12-inch fucking color magnet box television."
I'll see what I can.
And then
do
we would play
seat.
It, and it would I just like we would make the whole. We'd set up the whole situation so we could like immerse ourselves cinematically.
Careful.
And I still have that feeling. Except instead of my little brother, it's you people. And I love it. I love that feeling about being excited about games. It's like so few things about one's childhood remain, right? The world is a harsh and brutal place full of bills to pay and mean dicks on the internet. And like sometimes you forget that there's like joy and love and beauty in the universe, and then a video game that you really like comes along and you're like, fuck yeah, the world is not garbage totally, it's only semi mostly garbage, and that I think is really cool. That's a good feeling, and so yeah, I'm happy about that. Way to go, games. Sorry, I'm looking for fish because I need to fucking get some fish materials for my bag, my hunter's bag. Apparently I need fish scale. I'm gonna sneeze, hang on. I sneezed. Okay, alright, what are we doing? What are we... Did you know that fish scale is sometimes used as a euphemism for cocaine? Did you know that? That's right. That's right. You know who I learned that from? The Ghostface Killer. A kilo is 1,000 grams. It's easy to remember.
Our illustrious.
What is up, the first of the Sterlings? Sterling is a kind of silver. But Sterling, I think that you are gold. I want to get up here. How do I... No, I'm turning off your side quest. No, I said off side quest. Off. Okay, yeah, see, like... Fuck, stalkers. Stalkers, hawkers, Betty Crockers. I don't give a fuck about your shit. I'm gonna climb this mountain.
Welcome to the mouth squad.
Fiken. Welcome. Welcome unto the squad.
Calm, calm.
Hey, a merchant. Hi. A merchant gameplay. I don't think I actually need anything except her free sample box. And perhaps to sell some stuff? How am I doing? Oh, I got some capacities. We good. Let's sell all these green shitty ones. These green and blue ones. Because I definitely don't need any of this fucking trash. I think it's interesting that these have no fictional purpose. Like, they don't... Like, what are these objects? Like, in Diablo, at the very least, you know, we know kind of what, like, a stone or a rune or whatever does, right? It's like a magical object we put into our armor. But, like, in this, what the hell is that crap? Like, what even are those? Coils? Like, I don't... What do I put it in? What do I put it in? Ooh, pretty. Let's take a picture of it. Boop, 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 boop. Boop, 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 boop. Let's get some daytime up in here. Hello, Mr. Sun. Might be too misty in this particular valley situation. Oh, it's the giant French fry. Welcome to Casa de French Fry. Is there a time of day where this thing is not orange? Any time at all. Anytime. Anytime at all would be great. It's not orange. Any not orange daytime? No? Alright, fine. Forget you then. You're not as good of a view as I thought you were. Freaking Oompa Loompa land. Alright. Let's go clear out this corrupted zone. And let's ride our new friend. He doesn't know he's our friend yet.
Come on now.
Mount Strider. This game features heavily some Lord of the Rings erotic fanfiction, I guess. I feel like I must have made that joke already. It's too gay for me not to have made it. Okay, here we go.
And now...
Yeah, get him, horse! Fuck him up, horse meat! Yeah! Great. Freaking killer horse. Oh, the horse is way over there. Okay. Stupid horse. You're fighting the wrong enemies. Where else is the other corrupted in this zone? Did the horse get chased by them? What's even happening? Oh, maybe those are corrupted birds. Okay. Let's fire them then.
That's got their attention.
Oh, I'm shooting the hella wrong arrows. Sicilian Bull, welcome to the squad. And the squad is growing in leaps and bounds this evening. Everybody's squadding up. Welcome to the team, my friend. I just want to hit max level. Like there's a point of pride here for me about like beating. What the fuck?
It'd be fascinating if they weren't looking for me.
Autobots, transform and roll. Oh god, stop. What happened to Ravage? We told him to lay off the Energon crack, but here he is. Ravage, you've got a problem. Okay, I did it. Is that... Ram, is he still going? Where the fuck is he? Let's see if we can find him. Oh yeah, there he goes. Let's just follow him on his new adventure. You can do it. Clap your hands, everybody, if you've got what it takes. Cause I'm Curtis Blow and I'm here. Oh god. Here, just Sawtooth, chill, dog. What the... Okay, well, this is the stream now. We're just going to follow this magical boulder of shit around. Break it up. Come on. Just, what are you doing? Stop it. This is a little scary. I don't... Here, I gotta take a picture of it. Hang on. Save this for prosperity. Get some dramatic lighting. Okay, owner here, Alonce. Bring that exposure way up. Yeah, that's a thing that happened. Good. Fantastic. All right. Whoa, that was weird. All right, here, let's give it a little F stop here. And we'll make it all artistic and shit. Beautiful. I think it's fucked. And then he left to become the last boss of the game, the horrible mutant robot. Stop doing it, you're freaking everybody out. Jesus. Making my subs uncomfortable. Sorry, everybody, I'm sorry. He's like this sometimes. I can't take him anywhere.
Got one.
Okay, so anyway, let's find a slightly less horrifying thing to do than that mutated, disgusting mess. How about this Banuk figure? Because we actually only have two. So we'll do the flower, then the vessel, then the Banuk figure, and then we'll be done. There's only two Banuk figures left in the game, I think. Come here, turkey.
Our illustrious champion.
Hi, Ori Monster.
Welcome home.
Welcome back. Welcome back to La Squad Mathematique. Look at these fuck faces.
Damn, if that grass didn't move.
Yeah, the grass moved.
You
want some?
Sun's gonna shine right through you. When
present for your face. Okay. So there's like this huge wall here. Oh, okay, so the thing is right behind the gate. Alright. The stream title is a reference to Annie Leibovitz, who is a very famous photographer. But I could totally see how you might think that it's a reference to A Canticle for Leibovitz, which is a very famous post-apocalyptic story. Also, Kizito and Twainer, welcome back.
Welcome home.
Man, I love that they legalized Tintergold. You know, decriminalizing Tintergold was like the best thing that the new post-apocalyptic government could have done. It's time to stop putting people in jail for minor Tintergold-related crimes. Climb the shit out of this thing. Fish sticks. You're a great person and not a very good food. This is pretty cool. Climb up on the fucking thing. Wait, hold on. I can take a picture of this. Yes! Ooh, I'm a good photographer. Check it out. This is like her, like Michael Jordan jumping situation. I'm into it. Air Aloy. What up, By Design? Welcome back. There you go. I got to get her face in the shot. Okay, and then let's see. Let's see about this time of day shit. Yeah, cool. It's dark as fuck over here. Okay, so I kind of liked the light we had. I like the shadow behind her, especially if we're going to compose it that way. So, like, I like the color better when she has direct sun on her. That's cool. That's cool where the shadow's at there. I'm going to take one in color and one in black and white because I'm not sure which I like better. And then let's do another one in color. See, like if I had Photoshop, I would fade down just the yellow in the shot because I think it's a little distracting in the color version, right? The ropes. Like I get it's by design it's distracting, but like, yeah. Anyway, that was cool, right? Good stuff. Fuck me, right? Like, God, it's bullshit. Game, you're an asshole. You're a fucking asshole. Boy, you know, you try real hard, and then the game just embarrasses you in front of your friends. You feel like a jackass. It's fine. Yeah, good at photo, bad at jump. This is why the post-apocalypse happened. I can take down two Tyrannosauruses at once, but God forbid I can fucking climb a wall. All right, you miserable piece of shit gravity. It's not your fault, Aloy. Oops, that was me. That was on me. It's fine. You know, I can't get salty about a game like this and the way that it handles like jumping and stuff because I remember Assassin's Creed 1. Oh, you better believe I do. I remember that shit. And falling off of every goddamn thing. Shit. It was a rough time. Okay, maybe I can get another good shot. Oh, yeah. Super Aloy Brothers. Boop, boop. Bam, 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 bam. Okay. Can we get some light on her? Is it possible, or is it just going to get dark? Click, 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 clickety, click. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Look at that. That is fucking cool. Go, Aloy. It's your birthday. Cool jumping, because it's your birthday. I need to play with the depth of field a little more. Because I want, what I'd like is for her to be in focus. Yeah, there we go. But not the thing she's jumping to. Wicked. All right, double action shot. Now let's try to not fall on my friggin' face. Seriously, oh my, oh God, just climb. Climb the fucking thing. Jesus, girl, you're gonna give me a heart attack. Let it not be said that I don't care about my models. What? Okay. Okay, we're doing fine. We're doing good. We're climbing. Just clambering. Clambering along. Everything's fine. Can we... Is there something we can jump to? Go, honey. Go. It's an intense climb. Oh, shit. Is that a bad guy? You a bad guy? I have a device that'll tell me if you're a bad guy. No, you're not. There's nobody. Here's a big old nobody. Like Zeke. I kid. Alright, let's go get that flower. Jesus. Jesus, pig. Alright, so this is gonna be like a little more difficult because this isn't like a high up area. It's just somewhere in this zone. So we're looking for a triangle of pink flowers. Help me find that. So I need some kind of like fish finding device. There it is. Hell yes.
It's beautiful, that's why.
Oh yeah, cool. I got this set. Look, the third set is done. Wicked. Fuck yeah. Okay. Let's go this way. Let's go up this. Oh, look at that. The edge of that cliff. Ah, that's great. That's some good shit. Yeah, I'm gonna read. I'll read through all the poems once I've collected all the flowers. I think that's my plan.
Our illustrious champion.
What is up, my Chrome Viper?
Welcome home.
Hey, is that a goose? Well, it was a goose anyway. I'm not even going the right direction. I guess I could cut across. Yeah, I'm gonna go back across the water. Ha ha, Mad Adric. Ha 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 ha. Ha ha, the internet has plenty of fish.com. Yo, I'm just a post-apocalyptic girl looking for love. Trying to make friends in this heinous world. I'm really into bossy, slightly butch mechanics, Nora tribal cuties, and not dudes with mutton chop sideburns. Mutton chop sideburns are turn-offs. Turn-ons include photography, but not of me. Climbing stuff, falling to my death. Turn-offs include turkeys. I love meat. You know, I hunt and catch my own food. Dislikes meninists and shitty old priests. Also, not really good at, you know, human emotions. At least outside of a cutscene. You get me in a cutscene, baby, I will emote. I'm pre-programmed there too. Hates giant robots, loves killing giant robots. I blew off all your stuff. Where you going, coward? See, your ass was so easy to kill. So dead. Now, these guys, now that they're my friends, I can sneak up on them. What up, Fady?
Looks like that machine carries fluid in those sacks. Not sure I want to find out what kind.
You watch, I bet you I can. I'm gonna get this one. Get him! You're my friend now, Sacky. Oh god, oh god, oh god, hurry up. Hurry the fuck up. Yeah, destroy my enemies. Mine forever. How's that feel? Feels good, huh? Yeah, you love that shit. Alright, I'm gonna go get this figurine. We out. Have a good life, loser. Now, normally these Banuk figures, we gotta climb up. Ooh, hi. What's this? Do not ignore. Do not ignore this message. You've been chosen to receive a free starter pack of Satisfy. Oh my god, it's Soylent. Congratulations, you've been selected to receive a free sample of the revolutionary new dietary supplement, Satisfy. The amazing, satiating effect of Satisfy is made possible by the latest innovation in the exciting scientific field of micronutrition. One Satisfy tablet is packed with enough essential protein, fat, vitamins, and minerals to replace a full meal. No time for lunch, still have time for Satisfy. Take Satisfy on business trips and avoid overpriced vertiport eateries. Fucking vertiports. Reply to this message and we'll send you a free starter pack of Satisfy today. Act now and we'll throw in a pack of new Satisfy Alert. All the micronutritional benefit of Satisfy plus the stimulant effects of two doses of Caffey Ho. I don't want no Caffey Ho. Girl, shake that Caffey Taffy. Shake that Caffey Taffy. Okay, so the Banuk thing is like, you gotta scoop down here. Oh no, it's like at the bottom of this river. Well, whatever, there's a little guy right there. That should help us get, unless I'm just gonna fall. Which, you know, story of my fucking life. Oh my god, that looks dangerous. Let's go over here.
Easy, easy.
Who are you talking to? I'm like definitely not coming at this the correct way. But anyway. This is just like my freaking demise waiting to happen. This doesn't seem safe at all. Yeah. Nope. Yeah, like the figure is around here somewhere, but I just don't want to. I don't want to fall to it. Is the thing. Like, I want to die, girl. Yeah, like that's the figure there. I just need to get to it. Okay. I was hoping I could Skyrim that. Nope. Let's go. Let's go this way. Hey, this looks like a structure. What's that about? A little higher? Oh, hold on. Here we go.
Figurine.
Tektuk, there is much I would confess to you, but one thing I cannot. I did not kill Signak, our chieftain, who claimed to be your father. That night I was alone in my tent, drunk with cold wine, dreaming as I always did of Lily, your mother. Ili, your mother, and her sunset smile. You'll never hear my testament, and my offering will never touch the warmth of your hands. But I paint my mark in the light of truth. I know what I am guilty of and what I am not. I hope against hope that in your heart you know the same.
Blow!
I think it's Banuk.
Time to take a photograph. Let's get rid of her. Sorry, Aloy, you're ruining the shot, as always. Look at that beautiful ass waterfall. Shit. There's a beautiful ass waterfall right there. All right, now let's find the optimal time of day. Nighttime waterfall? Nope. Other way. Here we go. I think this would be better as a black and white anyway. Let's do that. Yeah, that's cool. That's really cool. Okay. Feeling it. I've been really into black and white, like, landscape photography lately. Black and white photography in general. I've been kind of all about. I don't know why, but I've definitely been, like, kind of, like, thinking about it more. And, like, been more into taking black and white photos. I blame pretty much every, like, significant photographer in the world. What up, Baron Greywolf? How does one address a baron? My lord? Like, it's... There's a specific thing that you call a baron, right? But what is it? I can't remember. Jump up fucking... Yeah! Bunny hop that shit! It is my lord? Yeah, okay, cool. Welcome back. All right, we did it. So now let's find another pointless thing and go and get that. Like this flower over here. My wolf.
Hear the ogle.
your royal dopeness.
Let's not join it.
And a good word up to you too, sir.
And a good word up to you. Yeah, isn't Baron, like... Baron was a thing that you could be if you were, like, a merchant, right? Like, it was kind of like a purchasable title. Yeah, because I remember doing a little bit of research on this when we did our first Roll20 Burning Wheel game. Right, Lord whatever rather than Baron whatever. The title Baron is never used. Except in formal or legal documents, right? So you're a baron, technically. Interesting. Yeah, landowners, right? Forms of address and title and stuff always fascinated me. Finding cool ones for settings was always something I really liked. I always liked Arbiter as a title. Calling someone the Arbiter. Obviously Magistrate is another one that I really liked. Magistrate, that kind of thing.
Thank you.
What's your favorite noble title? Fictional or real? Executor is a good one. I like that too. Harbinger isn't really a I mean, you can use Harbinger as a title. Yeah, totally. Like, someone who harbinges. Oh, Tribune. That's a good one, too. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, Marquis is real fancy. The Marquis Mark, Lord of the Funky Bunch. Oh, shit. I gotta kill this monster. Right in the ass parts. Shit. There's some real good ones. Like, the Romans had some good ones, like Praetor. Yeah, I like that shit. Suzerain? Suzerain's hot shit. Who doesn't want to be a suzerain? I mean, I guess it sounds kind of like Susan. So, you know, it depends on your opinion of the name Susan. But... I always liked Magus, too. Magus and Magi. Justicar. Fuck yes, Justicar is hot shit. Yeah, Japan's got some good ones. Daimyo. Oyabun. Oyabun's a cool one. Oyabun usually gets, like, that's like a title that gets applied to the Yakuza. Like, it's like mob boss, right? Seneschal, yeah. Yeah, see? Fun stuff. Fun stuff. Archon. So these are all, like, great, cool things. What I usually do when I go into, like, making a setting is I'll pick a real-world, like, military or something, and I'll name everyone in the military after those things. So, like, lieutenant, sergeant, all of those things, they'll be in whatever, like, language. It's also a thing you can do if you're just making up a language. But yes, yeah, I agree. The Protoss used some real good ones. Also, is this a combination rain and sandstorm? Because that's some shit right there. Oh, I think I'm on the wrong end of this thing. Okay, we'll have to go around. Yeah, it's raining during a sandstorm. That's great. If you look at Dune did some cool things with them too, where, like, it used mostly European, like, just European titling, but they let you know who is what by what kind of things they were using. Like, House Atreides used dukes, right? Duke Leto, Duke Paul, that shit. But Harkonnen used Baron, which put them, if you go by, like, peerage and stuff, it put them below them. Which gave Harkonnen a reason to be, like, you know, pissed about it. And I thought that was kind of a cool touch. Yeah. Okay. Where's my metal flower? I think that's it there. Oh, this is one of the ones that's just, like, far away. Yeah.
These are something special.
I'm gonna take a picture through this fucking crazy haze. Nope. Drink! It's kind of a cool juxtaposition, right? Like the water and the flowers. I'm pretty about that. Yeah, ominous. Oh, cool. Let's see how we do at the end of the day. I just want to see where. There we go. That's what I was looking for. Look at that. Oh, that's great. Castle on the hill kind of vibe. Yeah. Hot shit. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Photo mode. Yeah, that's some like Dracula fucking all kind of that shit. Thing. That's the like amazing thing about photography as like an art form is taking a real thing and presenting it in a certain way, right? Like it's not like photojournalism is about presenting a truth about the world. But photography as art is about taking the truth of the world and showing it to people in a way they might not expect. You know, taking a castle in a sandstorm and making it look like, you know, Mary Shelley lives there. Yeah, and that's a thing that I think you can do in so many different ways, like color and light, focus, you know, depth of field, context too. Like macro photography is all about that, showing the close. Like, yeah, look at how different contextually this is. If we were to do this in like color, watch. Watch. Let's take another photo here. Look at that. See, like, I mean, aside from the robot bodies in the foreground, it's pretty placid for the most part. This is actually like a really good photo just as is. Right? Like, presentation of the real, but by way of artistic interpretation thereof. How did I not get that flower? I must have died. Anyway, just some thoughts. Some thoughts about art. Thoughts and feelings about art. I believe wholeheartedly in the idea of participation in art. Like, I know that there are people who are like, oh, everybody thinks they're a photographer now because everybody got cameras and whatever, but I am super into that idea because think of all the art that the world is benefiting from that it didn't before, right? Like, the more we put the technology to create beautiful things in the hands of everybody, the more beautiful things we get. And that is some shit. There's gonna be a day, I think, where making video games is like as easy as writing a story. I think that we're gonna end up in this place where the act of creation is so rapidly empowered that we're gonna be able to make some like amazing shit, and everyone will be able to do it. It's also why putting technology in the hands of people in like developing countries is so important. Because think about if art is only created by if art is only being created by the rich, we're only gonna get art aimed at those people, right? Art expressing their opinions. And so, like, as for example, as you know, as smartphones, as smartphones become more and more prevalent in developing countries, smartphones with cameras, we're gonna get more and more photos from those places. And so we end up in this place where we're getting stories shared that we wouldn't otherwise. I saw a book, a photo book, not that long ago. I think it was Vancouver. And someone spent a bunch of money handing out cameras and money, right? Like, you pay people for making art. Handing out cameras to people in the downtown east side, which is like the poorest part of Canada in Vancouver. Vancouver's downtown east side. And so they're handing out these disposable cameras and being like, hey, here's some money. Go take photos. And when you're done, bring back the camera and we'll buy the camera from you and the rights to use your photos in this book.
Just stay out of your way for now.
And some of the photos that came out of it were just like, phew, amazing, really good stuff. I think it's a really neat endeavor. I think it's a cool fucking thing to do. More art made by more people. And just like, yeah, just wait until that's a thing we can do with video games. You know, like, that's kind of amazing. There's the flower there. Okay. I thought I got this one, but no, you can't ride the flying ones. Okay, we're good. What else? Should we go do this quest because we happen to have something else we can do near it? Yeah, let's do it. Let's go find Olin. I think that's our main quest, actually. No. Yeah, it is. City of the Sun, main quest. All right, we'll do it. Much as I am loath to continue the main quest before I'm max level, I'm gonna do it anyway.